Myself, Sunil Kalshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, I am going to explain the gate turn-off thyristor from industrial electronics. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students can describe the construction, working, and characteristics of gate turn-off thyristor. Introduction. Up till now, we studied the thyristor. Thyristor is the latching device. Thyristor is extensively used in high power applications. It always suffered from being a semi-controlled device. Thyristor switched on by applying a gate signal. It has to be turned off by interrupting the main current using a commutation circuit. To turn off the thyristor, it requires the special commutation circuitry. A bulky and expensive commutation circuit had to be used to ensure the proper turning off of the thyristor. The switching speed of the device was also comparatively slow even with fast switching thyristor. Hence, the development of gate turn-off thyristor addresses the major problem of the thyristor by ensuring the turn-off mechanism through the gate terminal. It incorporates the best features of conventional thyristor and high voltage switching transistor. It is also called as a latching thyristor. GTO is the current control device. The ratings are available in the market up to 4000 volt and 3000 ampere. So for such type of GTO, it requires the gate current 1/4 to 1/5 of this ampere. The turn on time of the GTO is 2 to 4 microsecond and turn off time is the 2 microsecond. It is less than thyristor. GTO is a 3 terminal PN-PN device that can be turned on like an ordinary SCR by positive gate current pulse and can be turned off by the negative gate current pulse. No forced commutation circuit is needed for the GTO. Hence, power circuit using GTO are compact and cheap. GTO has higher switching speed than thyristor, therefore switching losses are more. Schematic symbols of GTO. These are the schematic symbol. In the first symbol, the arrow represents that the inward arrow indicates that to turn on the GTO, it requires the positive IG, and the outward arrow indicates that to turn off the GTO, it requires the negative gate current. Current distribution used during turn on. When gate pulse is applied, this gate pulse acts as a IB2, and because of this IB2, the IC2 is equal to beta 2 times IB2, and this IC2 acts as a base current of the Q1. So effect of this IC1 is equal to beta 1 beta 2 times IC2 acts as a new base current of the Q2. So because of this regenerative action, the device conducts and latched into the conduction state. And further, if we remove the IG, it remains in the conducting state. That's why the GTO is also called as a latching device. Current distribution during turn off. To turn off the GTO, it requires the negative IG, means divert the collector current of PNP transistor away from the Q2. So effect of this, the collector current of Q2 reduces. So indirectly, the base current of PNP is reduces, the collector current of PNP is also reduces. So effect of this, the GTO turns off. During such turn off, negative IG causes current grounding or current pinching at the center of cathode junction, which not only slow down the turn off process, but can lead to device failure because of second breakdown. Current crowding is reduced by the reduction in current gain of PNP transistor. She's the schematic construction of ordinary vessel. She's the four-layer PNPN device. Anode is connected to the P region, and cathode is connected to the N region, and the gate is connected to the P region. She's the schematic cross-section of the GTO. This structure is also called as an interdigitated gate cathode structure. As compared with previous one, here N regions are diffused in the anode section and heavily doped N regions are diffused in the cathode section. When we apply the negative IG, the GTO turns off, but there is the possibility of current crowding. To reduce the current crowding and avoid the second breakdown, it is essential to reduce the gain of the PNP transistor. The gain of the PNP transistor can be reduced by using the diffusion of gold. The gold-plated GTO retains its reverse blocking capability but has high onset drop. That's why this methodology is never used. Second methodology, by introducing anode to N base short circuiting spots, due to this onset drop reduces, it loses its ability to block the reverse voltage but turn off process is fast. Therefore again this methodology is not used, because in this methodology the device loses its ability to block the reverse voltage. The third method is very popular, interdigitated gate cathode structure. Generally in the large GTO, the interdigitated gate cathode structure is used. In this structure, the emitter consists of many parallel N-type fingers diffused into the P-type gate region. Here, N-type fingers are diffused in the P region. Due to interdigitated gate cathode, distance between the gate and cathode reduces, emitter width reduces, effect of this turn off time reduces. It helps to minimize the current crowding at the center and increases safe operating area. This configuration ensures simultaneous turn on and turn off of GTO. How to reduce the current crowding in the GTO? By using the interdigitated gate cathode structure, the distance between the cathode and gate is reduces, so stored charge carriers are swept out with faster rate, so it reduces the possibility of current crowding. Why holding and latching current of GTO are considerably higher compared to the similarly rated thyristor? By using interdigitated gate cathode structure and by anode short circuiting spots, the holding current and latching current of GTO are considerably higher compared to the similarly rated thyristor. So GTO VI characteristics. As long as input is less than forward breaker voltage, the GTO remains off. When we apply the gate pulse, the forward breaker voltage reduces and device gets latched into the conducting state. By increasing the IG, the forward breaker voltage is reduces. And when we apply the reverse voltage, the device remains in the reverse blocking state. Whenever the reverse voltage crosses the one particular limit, VBRR, the device enters in the reverse breakdown region and there is a possibility of damaging the device. That's why generally this is avoided. GTO gate characteristics. It shows the relation between the gate voltage and gate current. When the gate voltage is minimum, gate current is minimum, and when gate voltage is maximum, gate current is maximum. These are references. Thank you.